Hey everybody, I'm Kurt Othmer from EEG Info, and I have a little bit of nerdy tech to tell you about. This is a massive change in laptop technology, and I have, for the last 15 years, really pushed everyone to move to desktops. I mean, everybody loves laptops. It's like, oh, but I really want the portability, and I want to be able to go to different clients, and I really like the portability and the clean neatness of a laptop, and I've always said, yeah, but desktops, they're cheaper for what you're getting, less expensive for what you're getting, and to really do it with a laptop. All of a sudden, what just changed in June is that Nvidia and AMD, the two big leading video manufacturers out there, they both came out with new chips. And these new chips are extraordinary, almost a doubling in how tiny they've made these little transistors. And that means that these use much less power. Much less power means much less heat. Much less heat means that we don't have to cripple them to put them in a laptop. So for the first time, without paying huge, ridiculous amounts of money and having a laptop that's this thick, we have normal laptops that have full desktop class video cards. And I wanted to invite you along as I open one up. We just got this in the mail. So I want to open this guy and show you what we've got. So this is the new 10 series video card. It's called a GTX 1060. There's also a 1070 and a 1080 and talking about a 1080 Ti. But the bottom line is this 1060 is already way more than we need. It's going to be able to do virtual reality, I'm told. It's going to be able to do, and we've got virtual reality coming for Cygnet. And all right, we've got a little pull string here to lift this guy up. The bottom line is these new laptops are going to allow us to have desktop class graphics. And that means Synchrony is going to run easily on laptops that may have today, where we struggled with that in the past, Advanced Media Player, all of these things, hopefully even support 4K in the future. We're going to try it out and I'm going to let you know what we find out. And we're back. We've got the computer open. We've got Cygnet installed and made some really pleasant discoveries about this computer. First of all, okay, so for the last 6 years, we have struggled with these integrated, mixed integrated and dedicated graphics chips, and where they've got both graphics chips to try to, you know, hobble along and help these computers save battery and have good performance, so they use a lower power chip when you're just like doing your email, but then when you're playing games, it goes to the higher power chip and it would go back and forth. This caused us no end of grief, all kinds of problems, specific graphic drivers that would work and others that wouldn't, no end of grief. This guy, one desktop class graphics card. Awesome. I also had a question about just some of the look of this computer, because it's really beautiful, but what's going on? Like, what are these orange keys here? Well, this is because this is a gaming-centered laptop. So people use this. This is forward and back in a game. This is left and right. So if you're in a dark room gaming, you can jump right to those keys because they're big, bright, and orange, and you can jump to them. That doesn't really help the Neurofeedback provider very much, but that's why you've got these cool-looking orange keys and the cool-looking orange display. It's really awesome. So right now I've got Synchrony going. Let me show you some of the other games that have occasionally given us problems on some of the less powerful laptops, and on this laptop are performing marvelously. So I'll show you some of those. So this one is Dreamscapes. This is the most challenging graphical environment we have. This is the one that we use to really test whether a computer can handle Cygnet. And we're not even running this at the normal resolution. We're running this at more than 2 times the normal resolution you might have on a second screen. Now, it's not full 4K, which is 4 times that 1080p resolution that you'll normally run. This is what's called 2.5K, so it's a little more than 2 times. It's what's 1440p resolution. And this is really demanding on this graphics card, and it's running our most demanding game, which is animating this beautiful 3D environment. It's animating all of this stuff for us live, and that's really demanding on the graphics card, and it's handling it no problem, which is awesome. This is another one that's really demanding. This is Tropical Heat, and Tropical Heat can really bog down on some slower, older computers, and running beautifully again at 2.5K resolution. Gorgeous. Particle World is a really beautiful new recent game. And one cool thing I can do with Particle World, I can hit N here and it jumps to the next display. Some really, really gorgeous stuff, high resolution, well-rendered graphics. So this is rendering really fast and live and gorgeous. Again, I can hit N and jump to the next environment, to the next display. Really gorgeous. And it's working so well on this laptop. I'm so happy about this new chip. And finally, everybody's favorite, Advanced Media Player. Advanced Media Player runs beautifully. Now we have YouTube in Advanced Media Player and a Kindle reader. You can also do movies and DVDs and all of that. To sum up, I wanted to do this video, so thank you for coming along on this little nerdy journey as I show you this massive leap in video card technology that is now allowing these desktop class graphics cards to run in a laptop. This is going to improve our lives over here in tech support as we're trying to make this stuff work for you guys. It's also going to improve your lives, much better graphics, support for all these things. Expect a new video as I test this out with 4K and with virtual reality, which should work great on this. I'll test those out and put out another video soon. Thank you so much. I'm Kurt from EEG Info.